Hey, aloha gang. Welcome back to another episode of On Fire Fishing Hawaii. This is a fish and dive show made just for you. So if you're into that kind of stuff, make sure you hit that like and subscribe button. Okay, on this episode, I'm going with the man, the legend. You know him as my friend, my fishing buddy, and my old fire captain, Captain Ron Johnson. We decided to go bottom fishing, but like near shore bottom fishing for reef fish. In fact, we haven't done it for years. I don't know why, because it's actually really good fun. Well, probably because I get seasick, but it was a really nice day. So we decided to get out there and bang the bottom and hopefully get on some reef fish. So, oh, and before I do, you know me, I'm a big supporter of supporting local and protecting the environment. So I want you guys to go check out my friends at Kappa Sun Gear. They make these awesome face masks and gaiters and all kind of other clothing wear, but this is actually made from recycled material and they give back to the environment with some of the proceeds. So I bought this, please go check them out. All right, so let's go show you how we rig all our bottom fishing stuff. I'll show you how I tie my lines and hopefully catch some fish and I can do some catch and cook for you guys. So let's go, holo holo. All right, it's another beautiful day in Hawaii, and in my face. Oh, jeez. I guess that's the problem with a flat bottom. You know, you're going to get wet. So, okay, we just hit the outside of the reef. You guys can see the color change, right? The deep, dark color is the reef, and then this ledge right here is the channel. So all I'm doing is, as we're getting to the spot, I told Cap, you know what? Since we're almost there and we're going slow anyway, I'm just gonna whip the reef. This is a really productive way to see if any big papillos or small lures are around. You just throw almost into the breakers or where the reef like gets really shallow, and they usually hit right when the bubble lands and you make your first 2-3 pumps. And if not, right when you come off the ledge into the channel is usually where they'll just jump up and just grab your skirt or your grub or whatever and then just rip line straight to the bottom, try to cut you up on the rocks. So I figure, why not, since we're on the way there, let me just go whip and, you know, see if anything's hungry. But obviously not. So I thought, okay, we hit the spot, we're a little bit deeper, maybe about 40-50 feet of water, and we're just gonna go try and do some little bottom fishing. So of course I have all my rigs preset up, and I'm gonna use J21 lures. This is super cool product. It's actually a local boy from Big Island. So you can see all the different colors and textures and styles and glitters and sizes he has. Super popular, but I really kind of like it. It has this like little Hawaiian hook tail if you look real good. So it's kind of cool. So I put kind of the buffet out there, a big one on top, because sometimes something big will come by and see it and hit it. I put the smaller ones on bottom. Usually the one closest to the lead will produce the most goat fish and other fish. So all right, wish us luck. Here we go. So you just thumbs up for good luck. And what we do is we just drop it all the way down. And once the lead hits the bottom, you really can feel what's down there. It's either going to be a hard surface, so you know it's kind of reefy or rocky, or it's going to be sand. Absolutely. And depending on what you're going for, it's either good or bad. So right now we're trying to hit reef. We want to hit a hard pack reef, bouncing bottom. Hopefully we get some moanas. Right now we're kind of a little bit too sandy, so sometimes there'll be veke nonos, which is that red goldfish. But we're going for more moanas, collies, moana, and maybe some tape 12. You know, it's a type of snapper, so it's super good. So we'll just keep moving spots and then just drop and test the bottom. That's what we do, you know. You just got to keep moving. Unless you have your houses marked, just keep trying. Just drop, bounce it. Just keep bouncing lead off the bottom, and sooner or later, you'll get hit. All right, let me just go. All right, did I get something? Hanafa! All right. Here we go. Ooh.
Alright, okay.
What is this? Alright, if any of you guys out there know what the heck this is, let me know. Because it's like a half this fish and a half of that fish. So if you don't know what it is, just let it go to let it grow.
Do you wanna?
All right. Let me let this bugger go. Come on, bugger. Oots. Okay. Sorry about that. Oots. Here you go. Lip piercing. All right. Here you go. Back down. Okay. Let me show you how we make our rigs.
Yo, what's up, guys? I'll show you how to make your damashi rig. So you're going to start off with about like 5 feet. For me, I use either 20 or 30 pound fluorocarbon. So that's about, stretch it all the way out, arm's length to arm's length, you know. And then I'm just using this rope just to show you, make it more contrast so you can see. So you can just tie a figure eight knot on one side, another figure eight knot on the other side for your lead, and you're pretty much all set. So the lead one, you're gonna make a lot bigger. All you do is make a twist it again, take this end, the bite end, put it through. And you see the eight in there, and you just pull it, and that's it. Super simple. Then you take this knot, and all you do is slide it through your lead. Get in there. All right. Then you just girth hitch it, meaning you just put it through the hole and on itself, just like that. Super easy. And then even when you're done, to untie it, all you have to do is just take it off your lead, and you're done. Okay. So for this rig, you can have your lead side and then your main line side. So let's just start with the lead side. So once you have this side of it, what you're gonna do is you're gonna divide this string into thirds. So just give you an example, and you can practice on your own and you get better at it. So let's say I want a knot to be right here, like a little tagline, right? So you have your main line, and they call this branches. So all I'm gonna do is tie another figure eight. So all this is a family of eights, okay? So you can make it fancy and directional, or you could just, what I do is I just take the line, make a bite, where you want the knot at. So you guys can see that, just take a bite. Then once you, where you get to have the bite, all you do is make two turns, okay? So it's almost like a figure eight with an extra twist in it. Then you stick this line through the loop you just made, and then you're just gonna pull it tight. And you see that? Look at that. So it's a figure eight with an extra twist. That just helps it from slipping to me. Okay, once you got that little loop in there, this will be your branch. So you're gonna just cut off a little bit right there. Make sure you leave a little, don't cut it all the way at the knot. You cut it all the way at the knot, it happens to, like, you'll end up, like, the knot might pull through. So now, you have your main line, and you have your branch line, okay? So now this branch line is what you tie your hooks to. So for me, I just go like this, regular fisherman's knot. Go five times around. But you just go right through, and then right through. And you're pretty much done. It'll be something like that. So, and then what you're gonna do is you're gonna have three branches. You're gonna have your lead, and maybe one, two, three. All evenly spaced, and then you can put your little grubs on this, or a little bait on this, okay? So, hopefully that helps you guys out. Give me a thumbs up if it helped you out. You can vary the size of the hook and the various size of the line. You also can change out this bottom section to a lighter line, or put just a smaller knot here, a smaller loop knot, and put a rubber band. So a lot of people put a rubber band here. That way when they bounce it out, if this gets stuck, the rubber band will break a lot easier, and then they just keep changing lead. So, okay, back to fishing. Let's go. Holo holo.
All right, so just drop it to the bottom and bounce them. Just like this, and oh, Hanapa! Yes, yes, sir. Nah. Stuck. That's why sometimes you use rubber band, you can snap them. Or lighter line, but. Alright, so this break line or drive backwards and get it off the bottom, and then on, drop bigger. Again, and Hanapa! For real this time. Alright. Here we go. It's a mini barb goldfish or moano. A lot of people just call it moana, even if the Hawaiian name is moano. But yeah, super good tasting, nice flaky soft fish. But minimum size, I believe, is 7 inches. So let's go double check.
Oh, yeah.
All right. Chico. Ho, oh, brah. How's these guys? Bro, they seen us catch and they come right up to us.
How you guys doing?
Uncool.
Huh?
Nah, I know them. These guys is two other firemen, Kopono and Tyler. You'd be surprised how much fish they catch on that little bathtub with an engine.
Oh, nice.
But I thought they'd come by and say hi, so they found us and just come say hi.
Yeah, well, we went inside and right by the outside the breakers. That don't do that. That was horrible, bro. Was just heating the rock's lead, bro. Holy smoke, that was horrible.
But she was bro, yeah.
We told them come bottom by us, but they said they're gonna just keep trolling. Hopefully get a papillo or something and then come back and check us out after if anything. So then shoots, guys.
Alright,
I'll
go pull it.
Yes,
sir. Hanapa. What we got? Oh, at least this one get a little head shake. I mean, not big, but it just feels heavy. Oh, feels like I'm big, big hage. I mean, you know, the heavy and get like a kick. We hooked the same fish, you know. Mountain in the butt. Come on, baby, be something keepable. Oh no! I told you. King Hage.
Oh, here, I got the other one you wanted there.
Hey! Alright, that's at least edible compared to this guy.
Check how fat this bugger is. Hage Master.
Ah, you broke right, my catch hook, you release. Sucker.
Bye bye.
That sucked.
Yes, that try, still shrimp. Drop some shrimp straight to the bottom. You guys will catch. Just don't tell nobody. But. Ah.
God, but you got kind of mixed species.
I gotta throw them back.
That's weird. that's funny.
The motor boom.
Behave. Look how fast it came outside of the crib.
Okay, guys, real quick. Bam! I still have a lot of aqua lure grubs and merch that was lucky enough donated for me to give away to you guys. So again, every week I'll give away one of these packs. So I'll put the screen, pick one you want, but just put aloha and a guess a number 1 to 50. I'll random number it and put it in the comments who won. So just, all right, good luck.
Up next is our catch and cook.
All right, so we got, I don't know if you guys see it, but we got our beautiful moanos. They also call moanas. We're gonna kind of do it like my version of a Chinese style. So I'm actually gonna kind of steam it in the oven. So about these size are probably like 350 at like 20 minutes, 30 minutes, depending on size. But what I'm gonna do is, I already scaled and gutted it. I'm just gonna put a couple of slits in each one. What this does is actually really helps, one, when I guess when you serve it, it's way easier for people to pick off the food. But it actually has a really even surface area, so it allows it to steam more, and it lets the oyster sauce really seep into the meat. So we'll do this on both sides, real easy. So this is, I always go with three. There we go. Now, so simple. This is a really simple dish. It's gonna have some oyster sauce. Oh yeah. Rub it in, both sides. And make sure you also get the inside. Oh yeah, look at that. And now, I'm gonna just put this all into a pan. So we have a pan lined with tea leaves. We're just gonna put all these inside. Opposite direction, that way they all kind of like just snuggle in there real nice, okay? So, once we get this, the key is, so I have mint, garlic, and ginger, green onions. So, you're just gonna take a little bit of each, put it all around, and you're gonna stuff some inside also. So what I do is I take these little juliennes of ginger and I stuff them inside. That way it imparts a lot of flavor while it's cooking. So you just stuff them all inside. Bam! Get in there. A ton of green onions. If you have cilantro too, that'll be really super good with this. But right now our garden doesn't have any, but our garden has all the rest of this ingredients. So that looks super good. We're gonna cover this tightly with tin foil. And just bake it off roughly about 20 to 30 minutes depending on size, and just let it steam. Actually, I'm gonna add just a little water. Yeah, maybe that's, there you go. Just to help it steam. And then when we're done cooking, we'll just top it off with a little hot oil and some shoyu, and we'll be all good. Hot, hot. All right, perfect. That's what you wanna see. You wanna see it kind of have the steam come out. It should look like that. Woo! Look at that. Perfect. Added maybe a little bit too much water, but that's all right. That's all right. More sauce. So all we're going to do is, now that the fish is cooked, we're going to add the rest of the minced garlic, ginger, and green onion. Just all your aromatics. Oh, it looks so good. So basically, this is like oven steamed. So you put that on. If you had cilantro, it'd be even better, but bam! And all I did was heat it up regular vegetable oil. But what I did was I added a little bit of sesame seed oil. Because usually most people use peanut oil, but a lot of people, especially at parties, I don't want to use peanut oil because you could have a peanut allergy and that's dangerous. So this still gives it that nutty flavor without any risk. So you heat up the oil just to the smoking. Oh yeah. And then you just pour it on top. And last, you just top it with some shoyu right on top. This will make a nice sauce on the bottom. Oh yeah. Oh, soak that. All right, so we're just gonna cut these buggers up, heavily salt it, and we'll do a real quick flash fry on this, and it should be all right.
All right.
Oh, that's the sound you should hear.
Oh yeah.
Lick your screen.
Yeah, yeah.
So I got some Nabeta, some Moanas. Hey, Dad. Hey, Grandma. All right. Yeah, yeah, hurry up. Eat it, Zion. Look up here. Is it good?
Mm-hmm.
What does it taste like?
It tastes like chicken.
All right, cool. How is it?
Want to
chair or something?
That's okay.
Oh, you like got choke. Ridge, don't choke again. Chew your food.
Fumble.
Take care of yourselves. Okay. How's it?
That's okay.
Oh, you like got choke. Grandma, how old are you?
Okay.
No, how old are you?
Okay. How old are you?
Old. How old are you?
94.
Oh, hey, right on.
95 in September.
Yeah, there you go. Woo. Hey, aloha gang. Thank you guys for watching another episode of On Fire Fishing Hawaii. Make sure you guys like and subscribe because that way you catch every episode. I drop one pretty much every Sunday at 6 p.m. So make sure you guys catch all the fun, excitement, the bloopers, and everything else. Take care of yourselves and take care of others. Catch you on the next one. Yee!